3, 2, 1. Living in a world now, do you understand your place as an artist? Your place as an artist is to think outside the box. It is to press your mind to limits of imagination that other people aren't willing to do. How we come up with great music, great comedy, great poetry is thinking outside the box. Needham Simone said it best. The job of the artist is to reflect the times. If we are truly lucky, the history we find will have been written by the fool who played the jester and recorded the truth within the jokes. In a time when freedom of speech is under attack in America, and that sadly is just the beginning of our societal problems, already know that current events will be recorded by poets and scholars, but the truth, my friends, will be told by the comedians, the jesters, and the provocateurs, but most of all, the troublemakers. We all have a story to tell. You're all a work of art in progress. Some of us progress faster than others, and some of us take a long time like me. Listen to me when I tell you this. It comes from experience. Don't ever let anyone break your soul. You have to stand on your own 2 feet and fight. There are those who will give anything to see you fall. Never give them the satisfaction. Hold your head up high, and in some cases, your middle finger higher. Put a smile on your face and stand your fucking ground. But you have now entered a world of darkness that over time, you're going to start realizing what is happening to you.
Very particular set of skills. Skills I've acquired over a very long career. Skills that make me a nightmare for people like you.
Okay, now what?
Buckle up.
Let's play.
What's this guy supposed to be, the ultimate badass?
I have come here to chew bubblegum and kick ass.
I
want to
have a bit of fun.
Groovy.
Hey.
See, there's a war going on here, and they don't take prisoners.
Time to nut up or shut up.
What are you gonna do for me?
What do you think I'm gonna do? I'm gonna save the fucking day.
We come into this world kicking and screaming. Not sure about our place. Not sure about how we're gonna make it through this crazy merry-go-round called life. Changes people. It makes you forget that once happiness could be found in your eyes. You thought your joy was bulletproof. Nothing was going to stop you. And trauma strikes you down, making you terrified of your own reflection. Because the person you see is not you anymore. No one dreams of growing up and becoming a suicide survivor. Stigma.
much for tuning in today. And how long did you do comedy, or are you still doing it?
I think once you're a comic, you're always a comic. Right. It never stopped. And I think that's just the bedrock of everything of my life. And I do a lot of social media filmmaking, which is like very small, short form video. And that really comes down to a joke. The structure of a joke. How do you cut a joke? So everything's comedy for me.
One of the reasons that I wanted to interview Kirk is because there was a whole other side to your life that not a lot of people knew about. Can you tell us about that?
Well, I was a very successful comedian. I was traveling all over the world. And then things started to kind of fall apart. One Christmas, I went for a walk, and unbeknownst to me, I had developed a staph infection, and it was on my heart wall. And it had finally migrated to my brain. And on this walk, suddenly, it was just lights out. And I woke up in intensive care, having no idea what had just happened. I almost feel sometimes like, am I really here? Am I really back? Sometimes it doesn't feel real.
I say it all the time. It feels like I died and I slipped through some wormhole in time and I'm experiencing the Mandela effect every day because it feels like I'm Marty McFly and I've like slipped through another time zone and now all of a sudden Donald Trump is president. He's in charge and people are... It's a kind of crazy madness that I can't seem to wrap my head around it. I don't really understand any of it, and I feel like Marty McFly just staring and looking at it all, just going, my God, how did this happen? How did this world become like this? And how did I end up here? A narcissistic, lying con man is president of the United States.
Wow. Hi, I'm Kirk Nolan, and welcome to The Box Vlogumentary. A lot of you are feeling this right now because I've been here before. You're feeling this fog in your head now. And a lot of you are just terrified of what, you know, tomorrow is going to bring. People are being evicted. They're sleeping on the streets. Food lines were bigger than they've ever been in history. And you're watching the propaganda talking about how everything is going okay. The stock market's going through the roof while the rest of us die a slow death. This is what conquest and submission is. I don't know what world you all are on right now, but the universe sent me back here. I keep telling my friends, the fucking Nazi planet. Floating mental institution in space.
Welcome to dystopian Detroit, the place that Trump called hell on earth. Join me as I travel the city, talking about the chaos on this floating mental institution in space. We are monkeys. Trapped in our cages, looking for answers on this road of perdition. So here we are. We're on the road to the abyss. You're in it now. You're in this endless loop. It's fucking Groundhog Day. Haven't you figured it out yet? It never ends. That's why the only answer, like Terrence McKenna said, is we escape through our art.
Given the insanity that we are seeing in the general public these days about the willingness to throw away their rights,
whether it be the right to bear arms, the right of free speech,
the right to assembly, or the freedom to due process, It makes one wonder what the hell is going on.
How did people get like this?
How are people seemingly arguing against their self-interest and feeling no compunction about it?
If you haven't noticed yet, I'm a troublemaker. All you have to do to be a troublemaker, just open up your mouth and tell the truth. This is America. This is it. This is what America has finally come to. While Wall Street and the big cats are getting richer and richer, this is what happens to the rest of the motherfuckers. I know what gaslighting looks like. I know what burning it all down to the ground looks like. I know what I'm looking at and what we're experiencing, and so are a lot of people. Going on in America every single day. And has there been an answer? Has anyone went to jail for the destruction of this American dream? No. Wall Street gets richer. And these people get poorer every single day. Okay, let's get something straight. This stopped being about politics a long time ago. This is about standing up for human decency. This is about standing up for what is right.
The illusion that you were living in has been stripped down.
Wake up and look at it every fucking day. It's insanity. We're just monkeys trapped in our cages.
People quite understand what they're involved in right now.
Wake up. This is not the American dream anymore.